Yo guys, Ghost here. So as many of you may or may not know, the Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War Alpha Test is a bit of a mouthful to pronounce, to be honest, and it's also live right now this weekend on PlayStation 4. So with Modern Warfare being a pretty massive hit for Call of Duty, and of course Warzone arguably an even bigger hit and also free to play, is Cold War going to be worth picking up and playing? So since I happen to own a PlayStation 4, I figured I would give it a go. So I spent about 3 hours on Friday night streaming the game over on Twitch, and then this morning I've had another few hours to play, try out all the weapons and get to grips with the maps and whatnot. So there is a fair chunk of content to try out here. You've got 2 to 3 different weapons for each category with a bunch of attachments unlocked so you can customize those in the gunsmith to your heart's content. And then there's around 8 score streaks or so, and then you've got 5 maps to play with. 3 of them are running a 6v6 domination and team deathmatch playlist, whilst the other 2 are of the larger 12v12 domination variety, kind of like Ground War. So is it any good? Well, let's start off with how it looks. In my opinion, it doesn't look great. I will admit I haven't really played any of the previous Black Ops games, and it was the newest Modern Warfare that really drew me back into Call of Duty as a franchise. Now bear in mind, this is running on PS4 and not PC or one of the next gen consoles, but I remember playing the alpha for Modern Warfare and just being, you know, completely blown away by the graphics, the sound effects and animations. I just didn't get that same vibe here really. And it also runs pretty badly too. There were plenty of times where, you know, an explosion went off just beside me or somebody called in a kill streak just as I was trying to spray somebody, and then my FPS dropped to like 15. And then there's the argument that this is just an alpha test, which I suppose is technically true. And whilst I'm sure there are tons of features, new weapons, kill streaks, and polish, etc., that they're saving for the upcoming beta build, and even more, of course, for the full release, but let's face it here, if you think they're going to completely revamp the graphics of the game between now and release, you're probably kidding yourself. Now, I know there is a very strong player base for the Black Ops games in general, and, you know, they've always looked a bit more cartoony and been more fun and arcadey, shall we say, than other Call of Duty titles. So I suppose that's in keeping with the previous games, and as a lot of people have pointed out, it's the gameplay that matters, not the graphics, and I couldn't agree more. Okay, so let's talk gameplay. So for me so far, I have encountered far less campers. I've also had firefights where somebody saw me first and I was actually able to flick around and get the kill on them with superior aim. So for me, I'm a big fan of this longer time to kill. However, the regen time for health is pretty damn fast. A lot of the time I would shoot somebody down to like 10% health, only to have them hide for 2 seconds, and by the time I've actually reached them to rush them and finish them off, they're back to full health. Like, it's seriously that quick. I think you only need to stay out of combat for like 3 seconds, and then your health will regen up to full in less than a second. And since there's no actual tactical sprint in this game, this makes rushing your target before they can regen health actually pretty difficult. The snipers seem pretty powerful. They're a one-shot kill almost all of the time, which is of course nothing new for COD, but it feels like quick scoping is way more viable in this game. You know, the ADS time is so much faster than in Modern Warfare, and right now, a lot of people are sniping, especially on maps like Armada, where you can snipe from one ship to another. However, over on Twitter, Tony, one of the game developers, has stated that they buffed the snipers in order to evaluate their performance without crossplay being implemented, since this is a PlayStation 4 only alpha test. And he assures us that they will have balance changes for the upcoming beta based on analytics data from this weekend. Other than that, most of the other weapons seem pretty balanced. I would say that the 2 LMGs are a bit lackluster and really don't seem worth the movement speed penalty that comes with them. So as is usually the trend, most people are running with assault rifles, snipers, or SMGs. Now the proximity mine, I'm assuming, is possibly the replacement for the Claymore, and currently it is actually a field upgrade on a timer rather than a lethal. So hopefully they're going to keep it this way to counter the Claymore spam that we see in Modern Warfare. The frag grenade, however, is painfully slow to throw. It takes so long to cook it. The first time I used one of these, I sidestepped out way too early and got shot in the face before I'd even pulled the pin. But throwing a stun grenade is almost instantaneous. I don't know, maybe they're trying to address the frag spam the same way they're trying to address the claymores. There's also a lot less verticality and people attacking you from just strange angles. You know, in Modern Warfare, you can almost mantle up anything and get to any window, which essentially means the angles of attack are endless. Somebody can be stood on the top of any rooftop or, you know, a little piece of a building ledge. Whereas in Cold War, there are only certain places you're actually allowed to mantle up to, like certain select windows, for example. And of course, there is no tactical sprint. And, you know, overall, I feel like in this game, you don't have to cover quite as many angles as you'll be used to if you played Modern Warfare. And that combined with longer TTK makes things a bit more predictable, tactical, and things are just slowed down a notch or two. The minimap is back to its old self as well, with players being pinged there whenever they fire, which means the value of having a suppressor has never been higher. Now, the gunsmith system is back from Modern Warfare, although it doesn't seem quite as intuitive and easy to use. On the weapons, you have to cycle through each attachment slot just to see what you have equipped, and by the time you've gone through them all, you've forgotten what you have equipped and what the perks of the attachments actually do. The wildcard system is back though, so now you can get a wildcard that lets you take 8 attachments on a weapon instead of 5, or you can get 6 perks instead of 3. And on the topic of perks, am I the only one that feels like Ninja doesn't really do anything? The footsteps in this game are so loud, even whilst not sprinting, and even if you have Ninja equipped. I definitely think Treyarch need to look into that. Vote map is also back, so at the end of a round, you can either vote to go onto the next map in the rotation or replay the previous one. Skill-based matchmaking is still in the game though, so if you were hoping that this would be gone, then I'm afraid you're going to be disappointed. I'm not a big fan of it myself, and I can tell you that I've gone up against plenty of sweats during this Alpha weekend, but yeah, I guess it is what it is. The netcode could be better as well. I've been in several encounters where I died behind the wall and it was really, really obvious both from my point of view and the killcam's point of view. I don't know what kind of a tick rate the servers are running on, and I don't really know what kind of a ping I have either, as it isn't displayed in game. Now, there are vehicles you can use, just like in Ground War in Modern Warfare. So on the snow map, you've got tanks and snowmobiles, and on the ship map, which is called Armada, you've got jet skis and attack boats. The vehicle mechanics themselves feel just like they do in Modern Warfare, you know, very basic and arcadey, nothing at all like the depth that Battlefield has. So the tanks and attack boats are really OP, but they can be taken down fairly easily by anyone really, even small arms fire. Or you can just do like this guy, hitch a ride and just magazine dump away. I think that's kind of a weird problem with vehicle mechanics here, the way you can just stand on top of the tank. So yeah guys, those are my thoughts on the game so far and how it compares to Modern Warfare. Obviously for me, as I mentioned before, I'm a Modern Warfare player really. I haven't played any of the past Black Ops games. So there are some things I like about it. There are some things I like more about Modern Warfare, but I guess the main question here is, if you're a player who only plays Warzone and you haven't even bought the multiplayer component of Modern Warfare, then is Cold War really worth purchasing? And I guess the short answer to that is, it depends what you really like. For me, this on the whole just feels like more Call of Duty. It's very Call of Duty, you know, it's nothing especially new. It's just another Call of Duty game. They come out every single year and there's nothing incredibly new or exciting here. It's a little bit of a breath of fresh air, there's going to be a new campaign. Apart from that though, it's pretty much just going to be a refreshed version of more of the same. So if that's what you like, then go ahead and get the game and you probably won't be disappointed. But if you're looking for, you know, a new Call of Duty experience, then I'm not really sure that this is going to be it. But of course, this is all speculative. This is only the alpha test, guys. And even though there is only a couple of months or so until release, there is going to be a beta test available, I think, on PC and on Xbox and PlayStation at different dates. So if you happen to not own a PlayStation, you will get the chance to try out the game for yourself before you take the plunge and buy it. So really, I recommend actually trying the game for yourself once the beta comes around. And I'm pretty sure that will be more representative of what the final game will actually be like. Alright, I'm going to leave it here for today, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video, and if you aren't able to actually get on the alpha weekend, hopefully this has given you a little bit of an insight into how the alpha was and how the game is looking so far. Leave a like down below if you enjoyed the video, and feel free to subscribe for more upcoming content. I'm sure I will cover the beta test as well once that rolls around. Have a good day, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.